We went on tour. There was a concert that was happening, and I remember G-Unit was on one bus. Production management staff was on another bus. So we were all on the bus playing cards, and when we got off the bus, one of the executives, like a top marketing executive at Violator, was like, "What were you guys doing on the back of the bus?" I was like, "Nothing, playing cards." He asked us to come finish the game. Yeah, I know your type. We got back to the office the next couple of days, and there was so much rumors and speculation that something happened on the back of the bus with me and a G-Unit artist. And I never wanted to be known as someone that slept my way to get anywhere. So I remember being upset, being hurt, and I was like, I gotta go talk to somebody. For whatever reason, Mona wasn't around, and I was like, I'm gonna tell Chris Lighty. I think I walked in and I saw him on the phone and I was like, and he's like, no, what's up? So I was like, you know, I really don't want to get anybody in trouble, but this happened and I just feel really uncomfortable that this happened and now these rumors are being spread because it's come back to me. And I said, now this is one of the top executives in the office. And I said, you know, I don't want to be known as a person that would do this. I don't want this to go any further. So if there's any way, you know, you can give me advice on how to stop this, you know, I just don't want to be looked at like this, you know? And he said, give me 1 second. Called the executive in and I'm like, oh my gosh. I didn't know what. And I'm like, I'm gonna get fired now. Called the executive in and he said, listen, this could be my daughter. Don't ever, ever disrespect her again. And he said, she works hard. You know, she doesn't need to come to work and feel like people are talking about her. Did you see her on? No, but you know, they was coming off. He's making an excuse. He was coming off the bus. But did you see her do anything? Did you? No, but I just assumed, say, don't do that. And I remember in that moment feeling vindicated. I remember in that moment feeling like he believes me. There was an unspoken, like, father-daughter bond that I had in that split moment. Me and Chris didn't have many words, but in that moment, I felt like my dad just came down and reprimanded somebody for me. You know, after that, it was never mentioned again. Chris will forever, ever hold a special place in my memory for how he just protected the sanctity of my work ethic and really made me feel like I was worth more than just a piece of meat at the back of a tour bus. And I could have gone down in history as the girl that was in the back of the G-Unit tour bus.